Okay, number four, we're asked to solve some equations. So in part A, we're asked to solve sine theta equals 3/5. Now the theta there makes you think angle, but remember, angles and radian measure are synonymous with real numbers, so it really doesn't matter theta, t, or x. The procedure here is going to be the same regardless of what we choose for the variable. Okay, sine of theta equals 3/5, we think. 3/5 is not one of the common values we know of, so we're going to have to use the arcsine function to figure this out. So the first thing we note is we think to the unit circle. We think about what angles we'd be dealing with here. And the sine of theta is 3/5. So where is sine positive? Well, sine's positive in quadrant 1 and quadrant 2. All right, so the quadrant 1 angle, where sine theta is 3/5, is, by definition, the arcsine of 3/5. The arcsine of 3/5, by definition, is an angle between 0 and pi over 2, whose sine is 3/5. So that's one of the answers in quadrant 1. How do we get the remaining answers in quadrant 1? Well, we add multiples of 2 pi. Right? So this captures all the coterminal angles. What about in quadrant 2? Well, one angle in quadrant 2 is going to be this angle. All right? The reference angle here is the same as the angle there, which is arcsine of 3/5. So the other answer is pi minus the arcsine of 3/5. And once again, to capture all the coterminal angles, we had multiples of 2 pi. All right, so those are the exact answers, and that'll do it for part A. All right, in part B, we're asked to solve cosine t is negative 0.33. So t puts us in mind of a real number, but we can associate that with an angle in radians. And if we think angle, first thing we notice that negative 0.33 isn't one of those common values we were forced to memorize, so we're going to have to use the arccosine function. Now, if we think where the cosine is negative, it's negative in quadrant 3, quadrant 2 and in quadrant 3. And so instead of using the arccosine function directly, the arccosine function directly would give us this quadrant 2 angle. But it'd be kind of a tough time to get to that quadrant 3 angle. So we're going to use the reference angle approach. So I'm going to let alpha be the reference angle here. And since it's the reference angle, the cosine of alpha is going to be positive 0.33. And then I can use the arccosine function and get the reference angle as the arccosine of 0.33. So this lets me get the quadrant 2 answer. T equals the angle here would be pi minus alpha, which is pi minus the arc cosine of 0.33. So that's the quadrant 2, one quadrant 2 angle. And then to capture all the solutions, I add integer multiples of 2 pi. And how do I get the quadrant 3 answer? To get the quadrant 3 answer, t equals pi plus that. So pi plus alpha, which is pi plus the arc cosine of 0.33. Oops, got a little carried away there with my 3s. So that's one quadrant 3 angle. And then I want to capture all the coterminal angles by adding multiples of 2 pi. All right, so that'll do it for part B. All right, part C, we're asked to solve the tangent of x equals negative 5. So once again, x makes us think of real numbers. We can associate those with angles and radian measure and think geometrically here. So to solve this equation, we think where is tangent negative? tangent's negative in quadrant 2 and quadrant 4. Since negative 5 isn't one of the common tangent angles, I can use the arctangent function. Now, the one thing we know about tangent is that the period is pi. These angles are going to be pi units apart. And so, as always, when we solve a tangent equation, we really just have to find one answer and then add multiples of pi. So at this point, it's really up to you what you want to do. We can go ahead and just solve this thing directly and use the inverse tangent function. X is arctangent negative 5, and add multiples of pi. That's fine. If you want to adopt a reference angle approach, call that alpha, then you would have the tangent of alpha is positive 5, so alpha is the arctangent of 5, in which case we can start x then as negative alpha, so negative arctangent of 5, plus the multiples of pi. Or we could have 2 pi minus alpha plus multiples of pi, or we could have pi minus alpha plus multiples of pi. Any of these are going to work, okay? In fact, these two solutions, you can see that they're exactly identical because the arctangent, as we mentioned in class, is an odd function, so that negative comes out front. So any way you do it, any way you slice it, those are the answers for part C. So that'll do it for number